In this video, we're going to talk about custom events. Now, LWC do support standard events on HTML elements like on click, on load, but there would be scenarios where you would like to have custom events built. For example, you want data to pass from one Lightning web component to another. An example could be, I have already created a Lightning component which is displaying me accounts in my Salesforce org. And the requirement is if I click any one of these, then it should show me more detail about this particular account. So right now it is showing me, suppose if I click University of Arizona, it shows me the name and the industry. If I put Gene Point, it shows Gene Point is the name of the account and the industry is biotechnology. To do this, where we have two components, the first component is displaying the account name and the second component is displaying more information about that account, we have to make use of something by name custom events. In our example, we have two Lightning components by name account item and account data. Now account data is our receiving component. Now let's look at the code and then we will take it forward. So let's go to Visual Studio and let's close all this. Let's first look into account item HTML JS. Let's first look into HTML. It's a very simple one where we are saying display me account.name, and while displaying it I just have an href so that it becomes clickable. On click of it, I am calling a function by name select handler. Now let's look into account item.js. Select handler is my function. In that, I have created a custom event by name selected, and I am passing the details about that particular account ID. That's why this dot account.id. So just to reiterate, we have a Lightning component which is displaying just the account name. On click of that account name, we are creating a new custom event by name selected. And over there, we are passing the detail about the account ID. Now let's go ahead and look into the second component, which is displaying the details about it. That is account data, HTML and JS. Let's first look into the HTML of it. In this particular component, we have added the action item component. So over here, we are saying, and this is the keyword. If you would have remember, there the custom event name was selected. So we have said on selected, when that event is fired, go and look into this particular function account selected. If I now look at the account selected, now in account selected, all what we are doing is we are saying that anytime whatever is the return, suppose we are over here, let me take a step back. We also have a class which is getting me all the accounts over here. So and that is getting saved in accounts over here. So in my account selected function, I'm saying that search for the account ID, which is coming from account item in this particular array, which is returned by the Apex class. Now let's look at the Apex class also. So we have this Apex class where it's a very simple Apex class, which we are saying there's a function by name get account. It's returning me name, industry, and I'm just limiting it to 10 right now. So account is storing everything which is returned by this particular class. And whenever this account selected get called from on selected account selected, then we are searching for that specific account ID, which is coming from account item, and assigning it to selected account. Now, if I look into this HTML, we are saying, then we have to display select item, selected account.name, selected account.industry. Okay. Now let's see this in action too. This is on the left hand side, I have got my component by name item. If I click on University of Arizona, it is going to give a call to the next account data. From there, it is retrieving the name and as well as the industry. To reiterate, custom events are used to transfer data between various components. And we can make use of it to make sure that the data flows from one object, from one Lightning Web component to another Lightning Web component. Thank you.